Chris for Boxing Now when we were at Jennings Gym, and I'm joined by Mikey Gomez Jr., English super featherweight champion. Mikey, it's good to see you. It's been a while. Just said it's been a while since I've seen you.
I've not seen you for a fair bit now, but it's been quite a reckon about a year, maybe.
Yeah, possibly.
Yeah. Yeah, not long.
But big changes for you. Not just the hairdo.
Yeah, it's on its way out. That was months ago. That when I thought England won the Euros, the night went wrong, didn't it?
Yeah. But you're over here at Jennings Gym.
Yeah, mate. I've been here
for
now
yet.
Since June, I think.
Okay.
Since the start of
what,
June.
3 months?
End of May, start of June. When I first joined there, I was still injured from my last fight. I had a couple of injuries and I wasn't really training. And then I just came here, tried it out, sparring with one of the lads that was just having his pro debut. And then, yeah, mate, things just went from one thing to another. And yeah, I'm enjoying it, mate. I'm flying, I've improved massively. And I just can't wait to fight, yeah. I just can't wait to the training camp. I feel like it's gone on forever. I just can't wait to fight now.
You said, you've been in camp for this fight for a long time.
Yeah, mate, I got offered, obviously, the Bellotti fight, I got offered 4 weeks before his last fight. He offered me on 4 weeks' notice, but I'd literally just joined there, wasn't training. Because obviously, like I say, I was out injured and I was spending time. I had a newborn baby at the start of the year. Obviously, I'd kept my camp with Kane, so I didn't spend any time with her. So, while I was recovering from injury, I was there. So, when they offered me the fight, it just didn't make sense. And Mike and Kev, my manager, Kev Marie, manager, was like, 4 weeks' notice, this isn't enough. And then, because at the end of the day, because I'm not boxing, I don't box to make a few quid, you know what I mean? Like, obviously, I want to do that, but for me, winning means more than just taking, you know, get a pay, get beat, oh, is what it is. So I'd rather lose knowing I went in there and give it everything and I had the best training camp and everything. You know, luckily, Reece, fair play to him, he won his fight. Matchroom, Eddie, Melanger, Kev, and Reece's team, they agreed to sort it out, and here we are, 3 weeks Saturday.
Reece Bellotti is at the new Co-op Arena, so it's on your doorstep where you live, actually, around the corner.
Yeah, mate, it? Next to the best stadium in the country.
Yeah, big city fan,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, so. Mate, listen, I've never been a believer in everything happens for a reason, mate, but for whatever reason, my fight's next door to the city stadium, the city in my Manchester hometown. Couldn't ask for it anymore, mate, to go on, you know, and become the first British champion at the Co-op Arena.
Yeah, some arena, actually. I was in there the other night.
Yeah, mate, I believe so. I've not been myself yet. I am going to try and pop down at some point before the fight and see if they'll let me in.
Yeah, you can have a look around. It's really nice. Like I say, you're around that area, but Beswick and Colchester, you're from up there,
yeah,
and Boston.
Yeah, mate, yeah, I live in Saddleworth.
It's actually nearer to you, that if anyone doesn't know, that it's nearer to you than the MEN, isn't it?
Yeah, mate, literally, the Co-op from mine, I'd say 15 minutes.
Yeah. So we'll talk about the fight. Reece Bellotti, British and Commonwealth titles on the line. Massive fight for you. But, you know, being here with Jennings at Jennings Gym, it's kind of, to me, it looked like it was a good fit, really. I mean, I don't know the background of how you've ended up coming here, and you can tell me that if you want, but you go back a long way with Mike. In fact, probably Mike knew your dad before you was born.
Yeah, Mike knew me before I knew me, probably, you know. It's mad to think him and my dad trained together and done what they did together, and, you know, I'm now on the verge of fighting, you know, becoming a British champion for Mike. It's a mad way it's worked out, mate. But yeah, listen, mate, his experience, his knowledge, he's boxed me up, for God's sake, mate. The guy become, you know, British title, he won a British title, he's boxed the best of the best, you know what I mean? Experience, he's forgot more than what most people know, you know what I mean? His experience is that high. And obviously, I'm training with the likes of Mark Jeffers, obviously Dave, his brother, very knowledgeable coach. And then we've got a couple of kids coming through, and that was the first pro fight. So, like, so gym's bouncing, mate. I'm learning for everybody, and everyone's hungry in here, mate. It's, you know what I mean? If you come in and you don't perform well, you get left behind, mate, because everyone's flying.
You look comfortable as well, and I can see when Mike's speaking to you. I mean, not only the respect you have, you just said, of him as a boxer, but as a person as well.
Yeah, mate, because I know everything he says. It works. Like, it works. It works. It works wonders. Even I've never been a good sparer anyway. Like, I don't spar into me. I just turn up and spar. But even now, in the last couple of weeks, I've been trying things that he's been telling me, mate, and they're just working. I'm like, how does a man know so many things are going to work? It's good to have somebody, mate, who knows that much about the game, telling you things, feeding you things all the time. Anything he says, I'd be stupid not to take it on board. And I can feel it's only just slowly starting. Everything he's teaching me, it's just every day I'm doing something, I'm like, I've never used to do that before. Things are slowly clicking bit by bit.
Do you feel like you're coming into your prime as well and it's all going in? I mean, it's like everything's coming together for you.
Yeah,
right,
mate, listen, I don't expect just in this one fight to look a complete different fighter all of a sudden. It doesn't work like that. You know, Mike, he's a good coach, but he's not a miracle worker. You know, I'm not going to all of a sudden. But I just think over the next 12 months, I'm only going to get better. And I think within the next 12 months, I will be probably the best I'm going to be.
What do you feel like yourself if you're looking at, if you look back at your past fights or, you know, the way you've trained?
I don't watch myself. Because there's been so many times over the years where I've been frustrating myself because, you know, early on it was known that I didn't really give a fuck, didn't really train, I didn't really bother. So, yeah, it's frustrating. But I feel like on the 26, when I win, all that goes to bed. There's no more, well, I could have done this, I could have done that. You know, when I win the British and Commonwealth, I've won every domestic belt I possibly come for win. For someone who wasn't expected to go very far, someone who apparently moved around gyms, wasn't dedicated, didn't do this, didn't do that, all of a sudden, you know, how many people can say they've won every domestic belt there is to win? Not many.
You know, you said about moving to different gyms, and I've been to a few different gyms to see it over the years. You know, what do you think it was you was looking for, and what have you found?
I just don't think I was enjoying boxing as much. Over the last 4 years is only when I started to fall in love with boxing, to be honest with you. Whereas now, I come to the gym, mate, and I love it. I love training. I love it. I love everything about it, mate. I love the pains now. I love going home tired. But I've got everything perfect now. Obviously, I've got Mike and Dave's my coaches. Mark helps me everywhere. Mark makes security. He takes me to track, my sprints, my swimming. Then I've got Woohoo Food, obviously sorting the nutrition out. I've got Palmer Nutritionist checking out everything's on point. I've got Matt Ross, he does my strength and conditioning, helps and rehabbing. I've got literally every person to do something. All I have to do is literally go to the gym, train, and that's it. It's so much simpler when boxing, when you have everything in place and you have a plan. It's just so much simpler, mate. It's not easy, but it's easier. Obviously, the game's never going to be easy getting punched in the face. It's just a lot more enjoyable, man. I generally do love the game now. I probably love it more now in the last 2 months or so than I probably ever have in my whole life.
You've got a lot to fight for, a lot to live for. You said you've become a dad as well. You was a bit of in the early days, a bit of a free spirit, maybe not a lot of direction as well. You probably, you've said in the past, you know, you was fighting, you had your dad was a well-known character in boxing, especially Manchester boxing, and you've got his name. So there's a lot of pressure in the early days. And sometimes, you know, I think you've said in the past, it was, finding your own identity really in the game.
To be honest with you, Chris, the pressure was to this moment where I'm at now, as in, would I ever be good enough to, because that's what this fight comes down to. Am I good enough to step to the next level? Because that's, you know, I won the area, defended it, won the English, defended it, and I've not boxed anywhere near my level and won, you know, without boxing, having to to the level I need to be. The biggest question in this fight is, can I step up to the level when it matters? Can I perform when it matters? And that's, you know, that was for years, that was my problems, asking myself, can I do that? And I probably didn't want to risk try doing that in case I didn't. Whereas now, if it goes tits up and I don't do what, then at least I tried to do that. For years, I just didn't want to try and do it in case I didn't do it. My stubbornness took over. Instead of trying to prove people wrong, I was scared of proving them right, kind of thing. So I just didn't try. Whereas now, I'm happy with myself, mate. I've achieved more. Not many people would can say they've got an English title, mate. You know what I mean? I've achieved more than most. You know, these people on the internet who say, "Oh, you didn't do it." I've done more than what they'll ever do in a boxing ring. Now, if I could walk away tomorrow, and I've achieved more than 75% of these people. So now it's just about trying to achieve what I watched out to do in this game.
You got your own identity now, aren't you? You know, at one point it was Mike Gomez, his son. Now you're just Michael Gomez Jr. You've created your own persona.
Not everybody, because I'm not everyone's cup of tea, but I don't mind that. I quite like that, if I'm being honest with you. But most people now around the game, I got the credit I deserve. Now people see me for what I am, and a lot of people respect me for being the fighter I am now.
So I'm going to chat with Mike and Dave as well, they're saying, you know, how well you fitted in the gym. Mark Jeffers as well, he says, I didn't know what to make of, well, I won't say what he said, but I didn't know what to make of Gomez when he come, but he said he's fitted in well, he's one of the lads to have a good laugh with him.
Big up Mark's YouTube channel, I'm Mark Jeffers. Yeah, mate, listen, Mark's helped me massively, I've most of that's good. He took a fight against Zach Chelle on, was it 8-9 days notice or whatever it was, you know, and they were saying to him, like, you know, that from, because he went from English title level to a big fight, and I was like, do you feel like you're jumping up levels? And just asking him questions and just learning little things off him, mate. He was in Canada last week or the week, whenever it was, a couple of weeks ago. You know, mate, the experience the guy's got here again, him as a fighter. So it's learn off someone like him, mate. It can only make me a better fighter. And all the knowledge that I'm getting off all these people, mate, it's just slowly coming together.
Reece Bellotti, it's a really good fight. He's on a good run of form. I remember watching him against Ryan Doyle and he got beat. That was a few years back. Was that one?
I've never seen the fight. Excuse me, why not? Ryan stopped him, didn't he?
He stopped him, but he's come back well from that.
Yeah, listen, Reece is... When I called Reece out, a lot of people were seeing it as something bad. I called Reece out because, for me personally, at this level, I think he's the best at, you know, at British title level. He's arguably the best. So, you know, when I beat him, then I'm the best. There's no one else I need to beat. I can then go on and move on. And, you know, I don't plan on being, you know, defending England British 3 times. And after this, I just want to see how far I can get. And then they'll worry about what level I'm at. You know, that's why I wanted to fight him. Because every title I've won so far, they've been vacant titles. I haven't beaten. That's probably the only thing, question left to answer. I've not beat a legitimate champion. And Reece is definitely a solid champion. You know, and when I beat him, I've earned the right to say I'm a good, legitimate fighter. Then there's no more questions need to be answered.
So it was the fight you wanted. You was calling for that fight, and it came up for you.
I want to fight the best at my level, mate. And then to the next level of fight, see, I'll call out someone else who's better than me. And when I beat them, then, you know, that's how I want to do now, mate. I don't want to keep fighting and defending belts and staying at these levels. You know, this is a big level step up. I'm crazy, but I'm not stupid. I know I'm gonna have to perform the best I've performed in my career. But I believe these moments are when I do shine the most. Kane Baker, everyone says it's a 50-50 fight, never got stops. You know, it spoke for itself what I went and did. And that was nowhere near. I didn't get out of first game, I was comfortable all the way through the fight, I was relaxed. You could see I was enjoying myself. You know, every time I've had to step up, and it matters, I've done it. So, you know, this is another chance to complete. This is what I set out to do, to win the British title. You know, when I do that, I can walk away from the game a happy man. I'm not going to, but that's all I have to do now in my life to be like, I've completed what I set out to do.
Well, your dad was British champion, wasn't he?
Twice, didn't he?
Yeah, well, he's twice British champion. And what a good one he was. I mean, I used to watch your dad.
But to me, that even, I'm going to win the Commonwealth as well, so it kind of balances it out.
Has it been a little bit like that with your dad, you know, because you was in his shadow, if you like, and that's what they say, don't, if your dad's been a, you know, well-known boxer and his son to look at, you know, Hatton.
Yeah, mate, listen, I was speaking to Ricky on Saturday, actually, at the Steve Wood show, and there was a post on social media about me, Campbell and Conor Benn comparing us to our dads, and there was comments on there saying, oh, we've not lived up to their expectations, we're not as good as them, blah, blah, blah. People are stupid. That's what people are. You can't compare fighters, us three that are fighting now, to them that they're finished. When we retire, then you can say we might never be as good as them. But until we finish, how can you compare what we've done in a halfway through our career and what they're going to be doing at Oakbury? The stats are never going to outweigh you. You know what I mean? That's like saying in my first 20 fights, I'd have to win 3 British titles, WBU title and all the rest of the titles he's won. You know what I mean? Unless you're Vasyl Lamachenko, you know what I mean? You don't get them opportunities. Unless you're, you know what I mean, an Olympian and all that, you're not going to get them opportunities straight away. Boxing doesn't work like that. These idiots on social media. So I was talking to Ricky about it, he was like, yeah, me. There was me coming with people, I was like, they've never been as good as the dads, they'll never. Just idiots, mate. Idiotic people doing, saying to other things.
No, I think he's a, you know, kind of...
They were all doing well. Listen, yeah. Connor's flying, mate, you know what I mean? You know, he's on the verge of a big fight. Campbell's having a rematch with that kid Fairfleet, mate, first fight back, you know? You know, that alone, these idiots, they don't see that. That's, you know, that's a big thing for the lad, you know what I mean? If he doesn't win that, it's kind of weird, isn't it? Let's be honest. So Fairfleet to him with that, and I hope he wins. Myself, mate, I'm one win away from winning all 4 domestic belts, mate, that I can win. So I'm not bothered what people have to say, mate. I'm enjoying
the life that I've got at the minute, mate. I'm happy, you know what I mean? I've got a girlfriend, a baby, good gym, good people around me, mate. I'm happy, mate. I'm enjoying it.
I'm really pleased
to hear
that.
It's not often you say that, mate. You know, I'm flying.
Embrace it when it's there. Yeah, thank God.
Like, listen, mate, could be like, you know, one injury away from being finished. You know, people, the world's mad at the minute, mate. You know what I mean? So just enjoy, I'm just enjoying the journey that I'm on. And when it's over, mate. Until then,
it's good
then
to
I'll worry about it. Then I'll worry about what I could have done and what I didn't do. If I wouldn't have spent so long worrying about that in the past, I probably wouldn't be sat here now, mate. I probably might have already been a British champion, or I might have punch drunk. If I'd been pro 10 years, mate, so probably would have had nearly 40 fights now. And so God knows what, you know what I mean? I could have been sat here, a British champion, maybe fought for a world title. I don't know, some rob is that, or I could just be sat in the position that I'm at now, enjoying boxing more than ever and ready to have, you know, the biggest fight of my career in the best place in the world, Manchester. So it's happy days, mate.
No, Mikey, I've seen you over the years in different situations and positions and frames of mind, so it's really nice to see where you are at the moment as well. So nice one.
I'm in a win-win situation, mate. I've got nothing to lose. According to most people, I'm going to get beat. You know, it's another fight where it's another step up too far. In every single fight, they say that. So I'm.
They've got you the underdog.
It's another step up. It's another level too far. So if that's the case, they're paying me to go and have a fight that I'm meant to lose. What have I got to lose? I'm going to go out there, have an absolute war with somebody, try and take somebody's head off, and collect two new belts. I've got nothing to worry about, have
I? Do you know, like the early fights, sometimes you don't know who you fight until a week before or days before or whatever. So you can't really look at boxing like, but the last few, you know, you're fighting.
Yeah, mate, you know what? It's
how do you assess a fight now? Do you look at him? Do you think about it?
I'll be honest, I've left this down to Mike and Dave and my team, because I overwatch people, mate. When I don't watch them, and then if I don't watch them, then when I do watch them, I'll watch them probably one day the whole camp. Everyone like Brian Phillips, Levi. I don't watch them, but I'll watch them probably one day. And that one day, I'll watch them, and that much where you think there's just no need. Like, so now I'll just leave it down to Mike. Mike's, you know, that's what Mike's known for, his game plans, his knowledge of boxing. He'll break it down, he'll tell me what to do. I go and execute, I win, if I don't, it's my own fault. So that's cool.
Yeah, that's what they're good at, Dave and Mike, aren't they?
They've been known for Kev. Kev Murray's been around the game. God knows how long, sorry, Kev, but he's been around long, long, long time. You know, I mean, I knew Kev when I was in Nappies, mate.
How is he, Kev? You all right?
I'm yeah, mate, he's excellent. Well, I'm hopefully going to see him on Saturday. Hopefully at the show, because he's got a show on Saturday. Is it 5th of October on Saturday? I don't know. Well, sent our English title, yeah, so anyone needs tickets, message Kev or any of the boxers. It should be a good show.
Yeah, puts a good show on.
Yeah, mate, he's, Kev, you know, we sat down, I parted ways with Marvin. It was a sad thing, mainly, because, again, I didn't think I'd fit in another gym.
It was after a while with Marvin, wasn't it?
Yeah, mate, we had a bond where, when I left, mate, it was sad. I didn't want to leave. I just felt like I had to leave. I just felt like I just went flat. You could see, if you watch my fight weeks and all my fight weeks, and you watch the fight weeks, the interviews I did with Aki, the press conference, so even the weigh-in, I was smiling and happy, and you could just tell there was just something missing. The spark just went, mate. I don't know what it was. I don't know why. I couldn't know the answers to that question. I just felt after it was time. And after speaking to Kev, we had a good chat, we tried a few things, and Kev sent me down here, and my first fight with Mike and Dave, I'm going to be British and Commonwealth champion, mate, and then after that, the world's our oyster, mate, we'll see what happens.
is it hard leaving a gym, you know, and keeping it amicable? Have you been able to do
not,
that
I'll be
in the past?
We've not, well, we didn't, it probably not left on bastards, but I don't know, mate. We've not really spoke. It's hard, mate. It's a hard one because we generally did have, for me anyway, we had a serious bond, mate. It's hard to leave somebody. I generally didn't want to leave him, mate, and I just knew I had to because I just fell out of love with it, mate. Like, it's, I don't know if it's because I was there so long. It's just me and Marvin training together. So it's just Marvin's idea. It's just me, you know. Sometimes you need fresh things coming in here. If it's not Mike telling me what to do, it's Dave. If it's not Dave, we have Matty Palmer, I think he's called. We've got Aki, or Mark will throw it in when I'm on the pads, or one of the other lads will be like, why don't you, like, it's all different voices, but it's just me and Marvin, mate, over and over and over. And obviously Mark from Basie would pop in. And then there was a couple of, there was a M down there as well, Marvin's other coach, but it was only like, it was only like a small, you know, two or three of us every time working. It was just small ideas, whereas now they're coming from all angles. And sometimes, mate, when you're at a stage where I am, I've been boxing a long time. I've been boxing a long, long time. So it just, I just went stale, mate, and it's just a shame. It's a shame it ended the way it did. I wish, in hindsight, do I wish that you're still a part of it for this last, for this big night? Yeah, I do, but unfortunately, mate, just, you know, boxing is like that sometimes. Yeah. You know, probably, hopefully one day we'll probably sit down and we'll be friends again, hopefully, mate. But right now I've got one thing on my mind, mate, and that's becoming champion on the 26th. When I win that, mate, then whatever happens after that in my life again will happen. But right now, 3 weeks away from the biggest night of my life, mate, and that's the only thing I'm focusing on right now, I'll be honest with you.
Yeah, I'm rightly so. Well, Mike, it's really good to catch up with you. Good to see you in a good place as well. You know, in yourself, I know this gym very well, Mike and Dave, so, you know, I'd recommend it to anybody. So to see you here.
Yeah, well, to be honest, I don't think they're letting anyone else in. They weren't going to let me in, to be honest. That's what you told Gav, they weren't going to let me in.
Well, did you feel you had to prove yourself to them?
They're a small thing, you know, a small team in there. Yes. They don't like taking many people on. And, you know, he didn't. Obviously, with the people that spoke about me in the past, Mike didn't think I'd be willing to listen and learn, but he'll tell you, when it comes to listening and taking it in, I'm probably one of the most in the gym. Everything he says, I try it. Even if I know it's not going to work, I'll still try it. You know, and the team in there is tight, mate. We're all mates, mate. Some of the things that go on in there, honestly, the gym's madness, mate. I couldn't think of anywhere happier to be. My last part of my career, well, the main part of my career, not the last part, obviously the main part of my career.
Suits you well, you fits
know,
well.
Yeah, mate, they're all, you know, the gyms, we have our laughs, and then when it's time to work, we have time to work, and as soon as it's over, everyone's in there, you know what I mean? Yeah, something stupid will be happening there when you go back in, mate, I can guarantee it. The team's madness, mate, I couldn't think of a place to be, and it makes me, I come to the gym happy, mate.
Yeah. And you know what, as well, they've got the kids coming in here and having trouble at school and this, that, and the
other.
Yeah, young,
mate,
know,
listen, and they come up to me and they'll speak to me, and I'm like, these kids, and there was what about Zoe was telling me, Mike's missus, they was watching me and my dad the other day and they were comparing us, and I was like, these kids shouldn't even need to know who I am. I'm literally just there. So it's good to see that you're helping these people as well, mate. Like,
and you can help us all.
I speak to all the kids, mate. I'm like one of them, mate. I'm a numpty myself. So it's just good, mate. The gym's just flying, mate. It's a happy place for me. We come from Manchester, mate. Well, Saddleworth. Every day, mate, you know, it's like, it takes us an hour and a half some days. And, you know, me 3-4 years ago would not have done that, mate. I wouldn't have done that. Whereas now, I enjoy coming here, the journey here with Mark. We have a crack, we laugh, you know, we'll talk about absolute nonsense, probably. Mainly Man United getting beat on his fuming.
Yeah.
But, mate, yeah, listen, it's just all good for me.
What's say about Mark as well? He's there with you a lot, all the time.
Yeah,
he
mate,
does
listen,
a lot for you.
This camp, Mark's been the ace card for me.
Is that man in the background?
He picks me up at 6:30 in the morning to take me swimming, mate, to time a lapse to make sure I'm bang on him. I'm slowing down, he's shouting at me. He's you know what I mean, on the bad spars, mate, or the good, you know what I mean, the bad days when he's not performing, he's there like, get on with it, like, you know what I mean, you ain't got time to feel sorry for yourself in this game. But mate, it's a lonely game. This is not a, you know it. Boxing's a lonely sport. People don't understand. You're getting smashed in the face on a daily basis. You put your body through absolute torture. You know, you get illnesses, you get injuries. You know, it's easy to go home and feel sorry for yourself and be like, I can't do this shit anymore. You get the people around you, the right people, they push you through it, mate, and it's good.
Mikey, good to see you. All the very, very best.
Big Dave will drop it to you. Ooh, Dave. Yeah, thank you, Chris. Shout out to yourself, mate, as always. Aki and Peter was asking me to get on the thing. I am going to get down eventually, hopefully.
Going to get you on the podcast, yeah?
Yeah, mate.
Bring them belts
down. He asked
me
to get on there a few weeks ago, mate, but literally, my mind's just been...
No. Get the fight out of the way.
Yeah, so shout out Aki and Peter for, you know, even asking me to get on there. That's a... No, them mans don't need me on there. They're the fighters here, so I appreciate them. Appreciate yourself, Chris. All my sponsors. Twins. Woohoo Food, nutritionist Paul, obviously Matt Ross, my strength conditioner. You've got sponsors, I can't think. Heroes and Legends, obviously Bay Security, NNR Demolition.
A few now, Mikey.
Yeah, mate, fuck me, my brain's gone blank.
A lot of people over the years have helped, even if, you know, the gyms you've been to and the training you've had and people have put stuff into you over the years. You are where you are now, and you've got people helping you along the way.
Most importantly, mate, more than anything, shout out to all my fans, everyone that's buying tickets for my fights.
You build up a right fan base,
yeah, mate. From where I was 5-6 years ago to where I am now, mate. Listen, the promoters like Eddie Earn, mate, the big, you know, one of the best promoter in the world, talking about me being a big ticket seller, mate. That's not, you know, that's down to, I don't ask anyone to come, mate. These people that support me through and through, they message me, they want to come and support me. I never ask, they gas me. That's, you know, that's what real supporters I have, mate. Every lot of shout to every single one of them about them. Would I be here at this moment about to have this fight? Probably not, mate. They've helped me get recognised as well in my fighting. So I appreciate them, and on the 26th, we're all going to go out there and enjoy the best night of my career.
I wish you all the very best, mate. Thank you very much. Good luck. God bless.